Hello, hello, Mordimer here, and welcome to another game played by famous people, and this time Emperor Napoleon Bonaparte of France. And the game was played in 1804 in Malmaison Castle. It's a suburbs of Paris for now, but at that time Napoleon lived there, and Napoleon gonna play as white. I estimate his strength of 1500, so feel free to disagree. This is the rough estimation. Napoleon was the genius on the battlefield. However, on the chessboard, maybe a slightly less, but it's still quite a decent game. And his opponent, Madame du Remusat, and she was the Dame du Palais, and she served to Empress Josephine, the wife of Napoleon Bonaparte. She was very smart person, as you see. She could play chess. In this game, she gonna play as black, and I would like to show you the picture. So here we go. Napoleon Bonaparte plays against Madame de Remusat, and Madame is completely naked for some reason. I'm not sure why, but feel free to drop the comment. Maybe you have some idea. As you see, her dress and her bra is next to the chessboard, on the chair, and behind we have Niccolo Paganini, very famous Italian musician. I'm not sure if he was in the castle at that time. However, he definitely lived at that time, so that's possible. So without further ado, let's see what happened on the board. Napoleon opened with knight on c3, van Giet opening, very rare, and now we have e5, reverse Nimzowicz. And for those you don't know, Magnus Carlsen sometimes played the Nimzowicz defense. After e4 he plays knight on c6. For example, he played that in the famous game against Bill Gates. If you haven't seen that, you can check over there. And here, after e5, Napoleon played knight on f3. So he likes the cavalry not only on the battlefield but also on the chessboard. We have d6 defending as the pawn was under attack, and now e4 opening the diagonal for the light square bishop, f5 challenging the center, and now h3, very mysterious move. However, there are some information that this could be played with the opposite colors. That means Madame de Remusat played as white, and this is the extra move, just to keep, you know, the tempo and the situation on the board. And I will show you at the end the game played with the opposite colors. Here we have f takes on e4, knight takes on e4, and now knight on c6. And in this position, Napoleon Bonaparte blundered, and he played a knight f on g5. The problem is, this knight is under attack, and this defender of this knight can be attacked as well. So two pieces can be under attack. So in this position, actually bishop on b5 would be the most natural move, or moving this knight to g3. However, Napoleon played knight f on g5, and he played very, very aggressively. Madame de Remusat played d5, attacking the knight, the best move in the position, and now queen on h5 with check. We have g6 blocking that, and now queen on f3. So as you see, the knight is under attack, and if the knight is moved, also this knight is under attack. However, Napoleon threatens the checkmate on f7, so black has to play something. The best move in the position would be bishop on f5 or queen on d7, queen on e7, just defending it. So for example, I will show you one of the ideas. Bishop on f5, and now everything is fine. This knight gonna fall, and if white tries something like g4, kick the bishop, the problem is knight on d4 with the attack on the queen. So queen has to be moved from there, queen on d3, and now black gonna win the material. Now the queen is under attack. Still the knight is under attack, so knight on e4, let's say bishop on d7, and black has one extra piece, so it's completely winning for black. So this could be played. However, we have knight on h6, defending f7. However, the problem is this knight was also defender of f6. Now f6 is a weakened square, so Napoleon immediately jumps to f6 with check with the tempo. So we have check, king on e7, and now now knight on d5. So check again, king on d6. And here, very nice move, knight on e4, sacrificing the knight in the center. It shouldn't be actually taken. However, the position is completely lost. In this position, Madame de Remusat took the knight. So we have king on d5, and now feel free to pause the video and find the checkmate, forced checkmate in 3 moves while I enjoy my cup of tea. Okay, ready? Not very complicated. However, Napoleon sacrificed yet another piece, bishop on c4. We have king on c4 and now queen on b3. The king has to be moved and the only square is d4. So we have king on d4 and after queen on d3, this is a checkmate. And now why this move h3 is considered as a strange? Because probably it's very possible that we had the different game. The game started with e4 and here Madame de Remusat started. So e4 and after knight on c6, d3, knight on f6, f4, e5. So as you see, very similar position, just we don't have this h6 because it's not needed if Napoleon play as black. F takes on e5 and the game continues the same way. Here, of course, knight f on g4, the blunder, d4, queen on h4, g3, queen on f6, and this knight on h3 instead of bishop on f4. This could be played. However, now we have the same knight on f3, king on e2, knight on d4, king on d3, knight on e5, sacrifice, and after king on d4, bishop on c5, sacrifice of the bishop, and now queen on b6, and that's a checkmate. So as you see, this is more logical without this strange move, but as I said, this position matches exactly the painting. So now, what just happened here? It's the part of propaganda, it's just, you know, not the real game. I believe it's the real game, it's not, you know, the high level, and this could be played by Napoleon Bonaparte. Feel free to disagree, drop the comment if you don't agree, and if you like this video, press like. If for some reason you don't like it, press unlike, and don't forget to subscribe, smash the bell button. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.